Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our first time single take on his reaction to HIGHASAKITE. Yeah.
High as a kite, it is. It's pronounced high as a kite.
Okay.
Yeah, the patron had mentioned it, I remember, in okay. The message.
Okay. I thought that is some Japanese term or something like that. Nice. And it's gonna be a reaction for the song Elastic State of Mind. Right? Let's get started.
Yeah.
It's a request of our patron Jono.
Yeah, we'll have a discussion about this song afterwards, how we liked it, how we, if there's something we didn't like, we'll mention that too. And we'll give an open, honest review as we always do. Let's get started. High as a kite.
High as a kite.
Elastic state of mind.
None of those games, love. I want none of those games, love. None of those games, love. I want none of those games, love. Oh, it took days to cross the desert. It's like a copy of a copy. My mind in a haze of delusion, but nothing made sense. There be you. Somebody holds you close. You are mine. You are mine. And if somebody tears your clothes off, you are mine. You are mine. And you lost the state of mind. Ooh, I don't know if I'm hallucinating.
Music genre.
Mm-hmm.
Wonderful, wonderful. Very, very much similar to the title, Elastic State of Mind. That's exactly what she's referring to. What a nice voice, sweet voice. Matches the tone of the music so well. Interesting song and very nice impression it has made on me, this artist, High as a Kite. Might be the DJ along with another singer, not really sure, based on previous requests by this patron and other patrons in this genre. Yeah. It is well known that in EDM, often the DJs use vocalists for their, obviously, because they are the ones mixing it and creating the music, so they have another singer who does the rest of the job. So this may be the same case here. The voice sounds very familiar. I'm not sure where I've heard her voice, but very, very familiar. What are your thoughts, Kirti, on this? Elastic State of Mind by High as a Kite.
You're going to repeat that a lot, I know.
Open and honest reaction to
High as a Kite, yeah. Okay, I like the song. I like her voice as well. I like the way she was pronouncing certain words, like hallucinating. That is exciting, the way it was sung. I like all the effects that were done with the song. Sometimes she's singing, sometimes other voices coming in, and the music, the entire mixture of the music, her voice, and the lineup was done pretty well. So I enjoyed the song. It's like a EDM dance song, as you said, and a light one on that. So when people, aren't really jumping, but you're relaxing and dancing, just having a good time, this is a good music for that.
It's
got a good sound as an ambient music as well. So it can just play and you will enjoy your time with dim lights and just having some good time with friends, family. This would be a good choice.
Yeah, it will.
Isn't
be.
It? Yeah.
Definitely. Yeah, any thoughts on the voice or anything else?
I like her voice. Her voice actually stands out among the music and everything else. Her voice is something that stands out. Very refreshing, and especially towards the end of the lines, the way she stretches it, that sound is very, very nice. Not that common with other musicians of this genre.
And the music is also very nice. Groovy
music was good, yeah.
Very catchy tune. And that Lose My Mind, whenever that was said, the way the music goes along with it, it's a nice hook, very well done. And then it continues very smoothly into the remainder of the song's tune. So it's very brilliantly done. The mixing
is done
very smoothly, nicely. It's a really nice song, yeah. The only thing is, obviously, we have mentioned it in recent times, the only thing with artists like these is, I don't think, there are many people who have heard them in Asia as well as Africa. The algorithm favors us to go to those parts first. So while we still go to the fans of High as a Kite in other parts of the world, maybe in Europe, wherever they are from, we do go to them, but the fact is we go to them last. Because of our geographic location,
and
we go to them last.
Freshness of the reaction by then.
So one thing needs to be understood, it's not helpful to the channel much. Because by the time it gets to them, the views are very, very low. And, the interest in, because it's such an important thing, the thumbnails on YouTube with the views showing there below it, such an important thing, and the time when it was published.
Yeah.
If these things weren't there, it was just like
actually,
a video blog. If it wasn't there,
it
would have made a huge difference to how our videos
To everyone.
All over the world, it would be equal.
Yeah.
But because those things are put by YouTube, the likes, dislikes, once you enter, that makes a difference. But firstly only, the thumbnail itself and below it, the likes shown. I mean the views as well as the time published.
How long ago,
So by the time it gets to the European fans of High as a Kite, if there are many fans,
the perception is,
oh, this video is not doing well. It's been one day since it's published. Because by the time it gets to the European fans, it takes many hours, one day. Subscribers, of course, may get it if they hit the bell icon, but the others don't get it. That's why we are insisting on giving us requests, which, you probably know that they're very popular all over the world. We can't do all the research for our patrons. We are trying. We are building lists. So I feel sad about that this song, even though it's good, it may not do well.
Sounds great, yeah.
It's just against the algorithm. So, I'll give you an example of big artists from that part. You may have
ABBA.
ABBA is world famous. ABBA is world famous. I'm saying big artists in that part, not worldwide. So if you talk about an artist like, Nightwish or King Diamond from Scandinavian countries, they they will do well, very well in that part of the world. But what happens to their videos? Their own analytics will tell you that.
Mm-hmm.
Their videos outside Scandinavia and rest of Europe, what will happen? They don't do well. Maybe less than 10% of their views, comments, etc. come from outside Europe. So even they have the same algorithm. It's not that we are talking something weird here. It's not rocket science. It's basically about the location. The YouTube algorithm is about location. So High as a Kite, it will do well in that part of the world. Then it will spread to other parts. Similarly for an American artist, the American artist will first do well in America. And then it will come to India, Africa last. So by the time it reaches here, the impression is already made. If it's doing very well, people
it does well
here
as well, yeah. And the things that are already, you know, flop there, they don't reach till here.
Yeah, so I wish the best for these kind of artists who are requested on our channel by patrons. Because I know it's against the luck. It's against our luck and their luck too.
Actually, you know, the luck is made by YouTube. If only the views were removed, I think
The views and the time published were removed, right? Mm-hmm. Even in the recommendation, even in search results, even in the, you know, when showing in the newsfeed to people, automatically it would make a big difference to the whole world. Not just someone in India, not just someone from Sweden or Denmark or one of the Scandinavian countries, not just someone in America. All the artists, all the reactors, all the people would benefit. And it would make such a big difference because it would be just... Yeah.
They would be so helpful.
Yeah, and we already topped in that. We have 15 years of stats to prove that we were ruling on the internet when these kind of parameters wasn't there. We were treated like everybody else. People came to us because that was what they wanted. And we delivered
people
the best.
People didn't look for location, that this location, that location. People look for information.
People look for information and we topped because our quality stands out. Here it's nowhere about quality. Quality comes last on YouTube. So by the time it gets to people, quality doesn't matter. It's all about the quantity that is shown below the thumbnail. And High as a Kite may have 87 views after 10 hours. This reaction, 87 views after 10 hours. I promise you, I know what I'm talking about. 87 views after 10 hours. What will that do to someone over there when it gets to the country of High as a Kite?
They think it's, whoa,
what is that? It's not a good reaction or it's not good. It reflects so badly on us. We have done a great job, maybe. But in our actual reaction and our discussion now, we are talking a lot of sense, which is helpful to the artist and the record label watching this reaction. But to the person who sees that 87 views after 10 hours ago being published, they say, oh, HIGHASAKITE is popular. These guys in our part of the world, these guys have got only 87 views. Their reaction must be bad. So even if they happen to go in, they just give a dislike and they'll go out. You know, thinking that, oh, everyone doesn't like it. So that's how sad it is at times. That's it for this one.
Next
we'll move
song
to the,
of High as a Kite.
We'll directly start with this one.
Yeah.
Yeah, no break in this one. We'll directly start with our next song. It's High as a Kite again.
Yeah.
I think it's a love song. What's it called? Lava, where do you live?
Lava,
yeah, that says it all, doesn't it? It is a love song.
Yeah.
So Valentine's Day is fast approaching.
Yeah.
We are having a lot of Valentine's specials at various times in the month of Feb, not just on Valentine's Day. So to keep it a month of love on Enoma, and we hope it works out because we are doing it our way as we always do. Let's get started. Lover, where do you live by High as a Kite?
Lover, where do you live? Sky in the clouds, in the ocean, I learned the lesson about bad ideas. We're really out in to come home, I guess.
Beautifully sung. Really enjoyed this experience.
Very relaxing. Beautiful.
Yeah, romantic as well. Romantic. Very nice romantic song. Sets up the mood
for
the month of February.
It also sounded like Sigrid way of singing.
Yeah.
So those, you know, taking it higher.
This voice sounds very familiar. I'm not sure if it's an individual artist as such, or it's the name of this artist is HIGHASAKITE, the female who's singing. But she has a really good voice. This, obviously, the lyrics were really repetitive here. I need not talk much about it. It's very clear there's not much in the lyrics. It's more about the experience of listening to it.
Actually, the subtle music and the way she sang.
The music is beautiful. You know, there's a guitar tune also going on along with the singing. Beautifully done. It's very mellow, soft, romantic music. And with the message is very clear, you know, when by the main two lines of the song. You know, going to send shivers down his spine.
Where is the spine?
Yeah, whenever they happen to bump into each other again or meet again.
Yeah.
So it's very, very clear what this is about. What are your thoughts, and we'll wrap this one up here.
It sounded beautiful. It just sounded relaxing, beautiful. You just have to listen to it and relax. And so I like the words put clouds, skies and ocean, because at that time, because of the music and the way it was done, you imagine those places. Mm-hmm. you know, those natural elements you start imagining in your brain because of the subtleness of the music.
Mm.
So it helps. Just putting those words and the way it was done, it just helps.
Yeah, so that's it for this one. Hope you enjoyed this reaction and let's hope we get past those 87 views in 10 hours.
I
Though I doubt it will, based on the algorithm, sadly.
Thank you for watching.